Hey guys, welcome to the Master That Riff. I'm going to show you how to play the main riff to Black Cat by Janet Jackson. And this is the version that features none other than Nuno Bettencourt on guitar. There's different versions of this recorded, an album version. There was a guitar mix as well that had Vernon Reid playing guitar. But Janet Jackson wanted a bit more of a hard rock kind of sound, so she liked Nuno's playing. And she also roped in Michael Wagner to produce the track as well. Same guy that did the Porno Graffiti, basically. And Nuno played guitar on this. So I'm in standard tuning. Janet Jackson counts in 1, 2, 3, 4, and we're going to come in on the and beat 3. So what are you going to do in the and beat 3? Slide up the neck. You know, just kind of on these strings, classic slide up and down. Back down, and I'm going to play the E string pan muted twice to kind of lead in. Yeah? Now, this is all based around kind of E minor, kind of bluesy, kind of rock kind of thing. And what you're going to be playing note-wise is like 5th fret the A string, 7th fret the A string, open E string, 5th fret the D string, and then 7 on the E string again. But what makes this riff so cool is each of these notes, just as we get to the end of the sustained note, you're going to bend ever so slightly sharp. So it has this kind of real kind of a kind of bendy, bluesy kind of vibe to it. Yeah, so we bend up in the first finger in the 5th fret there. And a palm mute in that open E string. Now we go to 5th fret the D string. And these notes pop out a little bit more, so if you give it a little bit more digging in, maybe like a pinch harmonic. Or even a kind of semi-pinch harmonic. And you're back to 7 there, so that's... Yeah? Then you do it again. Okay, so the little variation there is you're doing your bend, and that kind of comes in and to beat 4, so it carries over the bar. And then what I'm going to do is play palm mute E string, 7 on the A string, palm mute E string again. Okay, so if I put that together and play it slowly, you'll get a feel for what I mean by the rhythm. So when you speed it up, yeah, then we basically do that again to the 7th fret, but they have this little descending bit. Okay, so I'm playing a little bluesy descending thing here from the flat 5. So I'm playing 6th fret, that E string. I'll use my 2nd finger there, and then we'll play 5 in 3rd fret. And then I'm going to slide 5 to 7 in the A string to get back to the root note. Okay, so that goes... A bit of vibrato on that there. Now, as we lead into the repeat of this, we have another one of these pickups, but it has a slightly different rhythm now. You're going to kind of slide up. You've kind of got a rhythm that's like that. So it's like that. So what I'm doing there is I'm kind of percussively hitting down up, slide up, and then you got your palm mute and your open E string again to set up the riff. And basically you're playing the same thing again. And this is our little variation. So when we get back to this kind of E note here in the A string, we don't go, we have little double hits. And that's definitely a little Nuno vibe compared to the riff that was originally written, you know, on the album. So what you're gonna do here is 2/16ths. So I'm doing down up, then I'm playing the 7th fret the A string with a downstroke, and the 2 open E strings with palm mute again to set up the next note. So if I play that slowly, it sounds like this. Yeah, and then you get into the riff again. Now this bit here, I've tried to arrange this for kind of one guitar, so it sounds like it's been double tracked at least, and I can hear kind of two different kind of things going on. Either you go and slide back up to the E note like we did the first time, but the way I'm going to arrange it is I'm going to play the open E and the B strings with an upstroke there. Because it's definitely, you can hear one of the guitars kind of playing that. So that bit kind of goes... yeah. And there's another little overdub bit that we can hear, it sounds like this. So what I'm going to do after doing this, I'm going to play 15th fret the B string. Then I'm going to play 14th fret of the G string, and I use my middle finger, and I'm going to bend it up a whole step and kind of hit both strings. Or they ring together, you know, like that. Okay, so if I play the last two bars of that, it sounds like this. So that's essentially your two bars of four, your eight bars for the riff. So we play that all again, and it's almost identical apart from a couple of little extra kind of fills and things. So what Nuno does is, and the first four bars repeat, basically you've got your... So that's where you just hit the E string once there. And at the end of this, he has a little classic Nuno kind of flurry. And what I'm playing here basically is a little 16 note triplet. And I'm going to play open E string and hammer on 5 to 7 on that E string. Then I do the same in the A string, so open A string, hammer 5 to 7 in the A string. Then I do the same thing in the D string, hammer 5 to 7 in the D string, and then go back to the A string, like that. So slowly it kind of goes. If you want, you might add a little bit of palm mute. I mentioned before in previous lessons, Nuno's a great fan of that kind of muted, kind of percussive kind of sound. So if you add a little bit of palm mute there, you have that kind of feel. So the thing about that is you have to get that in two beats before you kind of play the repeat. So if you're in the groove of it, you just kind of go for it, yeah? And talking of that, after that, you basically play your second four bars again, you know? So this is where we have our double hit in the E string there. And then we end it off with a... So I just kind of went for that in this kind of one guitar arrangement. And then you... Into kind of the, you know, the verse riff. So that's it. So it's a great use of a kind of simple little motif. Apparently, you know, looking at information on it, it was Janet Jackson that wrote that in the piano or something, just that little... You know. But Nuno's version and the way he plays it, it adds this extra kind of, you know, Nuno groove to it. Obviously, that's what Janet Jackson was looking for, you know, a bit of a hard rock vibe, but the kind of funky metal thing, if you want to call it that, that Nuno has, just adds that little extra touch to it. Plus, you get the guitar solo that he does and stuff in it as well. So if you've not listened to it for a while, you've never heard it before, I suggest you go and check out the track because it is awesome. So have fun with it, guys. If you want the Guitar Pro, or interested in the Sound Slice page of this, go and check out the Master of the Guitar Patreon page. Also, you can check out Master of the Guitar on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram as well, if you want to see some more of these little kind of Sound Slice clips that I'm doing. And as usual, if you're interested in lesson requests or extended lesson material, again, you can check out the Patreon page. And I just want to say a huge thanks to my mate Paul for suggesting this riff and reminding me how awesome it is. I haven't listened to it for a good while. And it is a great bit of kind of Nuno riffage. Okay? So have fun with that, guys, and I'll see you soon.